Hi everyone, this is Timo Stork from NGINX, and as promised, we dive directly into our NGINX Unit 101 video series with Chapter 1. In Chapter 1, I will tell you why NGINX Unit is a thing, why it exists, what it can be used for, and what is our mission, what is our vision, and what are our inner goals to develop this tool and make this a thing. With NGINX Unit, we try to solve a problem that you already are familiar with. That today's application stack is complex. And from the browser or the client of your users or customers to the application runtime where your code will be executed or interpreted is not a simple one-on-one connection. There are proxy servers involved. There are web servers involved. There are caching instances involved. Load balancers. It is a fair complex system. And with the journey to the cloud and all the containerization and with all this like microservices approach, which is in a lot of places a really good solution, that got even more complex. So with NGINX Unit, we solve the issue of a problem that the application stack for your web applications, services, and APIs are getting more and more complex. And even, I would say, sometimes unhandable, unmanageable, because of all these different components. You are familiar with a lot of icons on that page. So let's start with the client on the very top. The client is our user. It's that tool our user can use to interact with our web-based applications. It can be a browser like Firefox, Chrome, Edge, or an HTTP client, for example, like curl for the command line, or an embedded browser emulator in a web app or something like this. So next layer is called the edge layer, mediation layer. We do have load balancers here. We have proxy service here. We have caching instances here. Sometimes we have web application firewalls located in this area as well. And followed by a reverse proxy. The reverse proxy is like routing traffic, sending traffic to our backend. Envoy, NGINX, AJProxy, Apache. You're all familiar with that. So, last but not least, the last two layers here are our application code and our application runtimes, like Apache Tomcat, Node.js as a server, JUnicorn, PHP FPM, uWhiskey. And those application servers, they come with a language, Java, Kotlin, JavaScript, Python, PHP. So the last like 3 minutes, we have learned how really complex this is. And with NGINX Unit, we believe there is a better and a lot more efficient way to manage this application stack. And by managing, I mean, we all need different pieces for our service to make it work and to make it a real experience and a real benefit for our users. So, it contains different languages and therefore different application runtimes. And you, as an engineer, you need control over the whole stack, over the network, the request routing, static file shares, web server parts, proxying, application runtime. And managing this on a stack that contains 5 or 6 different layers on different servers is complex and is very, very painful. And how we can do this? How can we give you the possibility to manage all this in a single component? Well, with NGINX Unit, we combined those layers into a single server runtime. Starting in layer 4, like from TCP overview, we are starting with the listeners. That can be a port 8080, 80443, can be a Unix socket. It's it's the piece that receives your client traffic. Your all the incoming requests network-wise are sent to a physical listener. So those are listeners in NGINX Unit. Then we can send this request to a router engine called NGINX Unit Router. And this router is very powerful. We have a separate chapter for routes. So make sure you check out this. But the router can manage incoming requests and can check each and every HTTP metadata or verb or whatever you can want to call it, and check what's the URI, what's the arguments, what the cookies, the headers, the host name, the protocol. And based on those values, we can make routing decision and can say, okay, look, I want to pass this request in specific application, or I want to share a file from disk, or I want to proxy this request to an upstream that is not on the unit instance, but somewhere else. For example, simple proxying. So, and this is how we think we can break up this whole complex layer-based approach and bring it back into a single configurable product. So with NGINX Unit, in this overview, I would like to highlight the core components we already heard before, once more with a different graphic. So starting on the left, we have a JSON-based RESTful HTTP configuration API. That said, you can send JSON-like configuration to unit in real time to reconfigure unit. The unit router, as already mentioned, is a very powerful core part of your unit instance. Then number three is the static file server or static web server capabilities of unit to share static files. And followed by number four, the application runtime of the seven different languages we support. Backupped by end-to-end TLS hosted on NGINX Unit. So we can encrypt your incoming connections with HTTPS independent from the language or the application you have configured on NGINX Unit. So this is very powerful, and there's a chapter about this as well. And on the right side, we can do proxying, and we have great security features to make your application processes run as isolated as possible. And we have another very detailed chapter about application security and all those C group, CH root, and run user features coming up in this course. So wrap me up this. If you run any of the languages posted in the first line of this diagram or the picture, and if you notice you have used a framework that is on that slide together with a lot of other frameworks we have not listed here, then you're absolutely invited to try out NGINX Unit with your favorite framework and try to modernize or start to modernize and simplify your application stack with NGINX Unit. In the next chapter, we will learn how to install NGINX Unit and getting our hands real dirty on NGINX Unit. So I'll see you in chapter 2. Have a good one. See you then.